Minister Paul Atanganji, this sounds like an Anglophone problem.
Yes, I want to say something. The word Anglophone problem, that is what I don't like. And that is where I totally disagree. We have 10 regions in Cameroon. He talked about the bicultural nation of Cameroon. It does not mean that an Anglophone who has as origin Bamenda or Boya, or a citizen from Bamenda or Boya, is necessarily an Anglophone. Because you can have people in their own land who are Anglophones. We have so many examples.
Who speak English?
Who speak English.
Okay.
And as you can have, I have so many people in my village, Akum, who are completely Francophones. They don't speak one word in English, but they are from Bamenda.
Okay.
Not even one word in English. I've seen the Wondos who don't speak French. So the bicultural nature of our country has to be respected. But what I don't agree is that I am having a problem because I am an Anglophone. It is not true. But that is the problem. We have problems at all levels, and we have an administration. We have the government is in place. Lawyers, they have their grudges. You have the Batonier, you have the Bar Council. Am I right?
Yeah, you are.
You have the Minister of State in charge of justice.
Okay.
Keeper of seals. I think any normal person, you have your problem, you go and tender your complaint to the minister.
The right channels.
He will discuss, he will consult, and at the end of the day, he will bring you a solution. But what I don't agree is that you give a problem and an ultimatum that it has to be solved this way and during this period of time. I think that is a very wrong approach. Let us be serious in what we are doing. Children are not going to school. Yes. But why are they
Anglophone children?
Why
are children in the English speaking part of Cameroon?
Yes, if I have a problem in my association, you have the Kato and Tak, you go and meet the Minister of Secondary Education, Basic Education, or Higher Education. It's a forum for discussion. You understand? Right. And we do our things gradually. Because when we go gradually, finally we succeed in one way. The Prime Minister in Bamenda discussing with people. You see, the government cannot be pushed to the wall. It's not possible. Because the government has always been flexible. The government is flexible. The government has always been flexible. We needed the GCE board about 20 years. It was given to us because it was an absolute necessity.
Yeah, the US day is rule, Minister Tanganji.
Yes, well, you understand what I'm saying. You understand what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that I don't want my level of education and my experience to say that because I'm an Anglophone, I have problems. I don't accept. I've been interacting with Francophones in many fields where I've taken the lead. You understand?
Yeah.
So let us remove this mental slavery and address issues normally. Give the government an opportunity to help us to solve our problem. Because no matter how good your problem is, if you use the wrong channel in solving your problem, at the end of the day, you don't have any solution to that problem. It's very important to
understand. Isn't it important to recognize a problem for it to be solved?
The English-speaking part of this nation, you said there's not an Anglophone problem. I will not be doing justice to my conscience. There is an Anglophone problem in this country. The fact that somebody does not speak English, who is in Bamenda, or does not speak French, who is in Yaoundé, doesn't mean that the linguistic barrier defines that I don't have a problem as an Anglophone. I mean, I was an individual, but as a people, we do have a problem as Anglophones. We've just talked about the GCE board. Let us look back into history. I was here already as a pastor. How it was created. Cameroonians of English expression expressed the wish that the GCE board be created to be managed by experts who would run it as a board, not to be run by a ministry. And they wrote a memorandum to be handed over to the Minister of Secondary Education. Before going to work, they left that morning to hand over the memorandum, and they were sprayed with water. A young man, I can never forget, lost his eye. He is now a blessed memory. And later on, the GC board was created. But only after the back board was created, which was already requested. I and then this Ebola was created.
Is that a problem?
Was it? No, it's a problem. Is it, do we need to spray people with water who came to ask for something before we did the same thing? If lawyers are talking about the common law in Cameroon, the practice of it and the administration of it, which the Cameroon government has accepted the existence of the common law and the civil law, who is administering the common law in the English speaking part of the country? Somebody who has not studied that law, yes, who doesn't know it, and is executing the language which the people themselves don't understand, is under a problem in itself. When we go now to secondary schools in the English speaking part of the country, and you send teachers who don't speak English to teach our children in the English speaking part of the country in a language which we don't even know how to call it, normally call it pidgin or whatever language we created, what are you doing? You are under educating these children not to become competitive in the world. These are the things that we are saying are problems. How do we solve them? Can we not have people who will be able to teach the children in the right language and interpret the things in the right perspective? You see, the strike which has been called up by the teachers and the lawyers has taken different dimension, and other people are taking advantage of it, which was not the original intention of the teachers and the lawyers. But we need to beat up the lawyers before taking and listening to them. Why can't we get to the table of dialogue and dialogue with them and say that what are the problems that we have? Present them, we listen to them and propose solution and move on from there. Let's learn from history. When Cameroon had a problem with Nigeria in the Bakassi area, there were people who said right up the high level of the military that let's go to war in Nigeria. We would have been in a bloodbath. But
Koshelo had a good president.
The people who had a different rationality, yes, said no, let's go to war.
Maybe you come in at this point.
I had a dialogue, yes, and the problem was solved. Yes. Why can't we do the same thing?
I'm afraid that we are wasting our time on side issues. Now, there is an Anglophone problem. That's why we are sitting here.
Yes, there is.
And every problem has a genesis. I don't want us to start by accusing Francophones of all the ills on earth. We need to go back. If we do that, we are facing the problem from the middle. First thing, how did Anglophones find themselves where they are? Don't forget, this whole business of cohabitation or integration, or I don't know what other word you want to use for it, has been going on since 1961. That is 54 years.
Yeah.
Or
55.
In Fumba, Ahidjo attends that conference full of zeal and intention, and he knows where he's going. Fonja goes there and is starry-eyed and comes back to a nation empty-handed. Up to this day, can anybody tell me what Fonja brought back from Fumba for the anger for the British Southern Cameroons at the time? This is where the rain started beating us. And so Ahidjo came back knowing that Anglophones don't answer back when Francophones talk. For 55 years, they have been used to talking and not being questioned or answered. Unfortunately, Anglophones have found their voice. I think that's where the shock is. And so I sympathize with Minister Atanganji. I sympathize with all those people who say there's no problem. But they are going to have to get used to the Anglophone problem, to the Anglophone voice. I don't even want to call it a problem. They are going to have to get used to the Anglophone voice. The Anglophones have left the kitchen or the outer house, and they are now in the main house, and they want their own room. Yeah. This is where the problem is. Let us not go round and round and round.
Yeah.
This system, this country, this government is going to have to get used to seeing Anglophone children being ministers of armed forces. They'll say, oh, really? But they have to get used to that. That's what being a citizen means. And so, this is nothing to do with, separating or seceding. Everybody is here to stay. But we have to review the terms of that stay. It is not going to be just on any condition. It is going to be on conditions of parity. Now, let me tell you what the Anglophone problem is not. It is not a social problem
No.
between Francophones and Anglophones. Yeah. It isn't. We don't have any problem as citizens in Cameroon. It is not a linguistic problem. Let me tell you, and I speak as the former sub-director of culture in this country. Language is a subset of culture. Language is a subset of culture.
Yeah.
Language
a minimal aspect of culture. Yeah.
You've been talking about legacies. And let me tell you, the Anglo-Saxon legacy that defines you is not only linguistic. Inside that language, there's a Minister Atanganji sitting here is who he is because of that legacy. First, before being a Cameroonian. If you are not happy as an Anglophone, you cannot be happy as a Cameroonian. And that's why I urge the system. While we have this, we may not have a repeat of this opportunity.
Okay.
Let the system listen to Anglophones. Proper conflict management consists, first of all, in identifying the conflict, admitting that there is a problem, and listening. I hear ministers and directors. I'm not sure that's where this problem now is. It is a policy matter. And the sooner government takes this